everyone, welcome to PharmaGuide. Today we'll continue the topic quality control of tablets, and in it we will study hardness, friability and disintegration test in this video. Please watch my previous video, quality control of tablets. From that you will have an idea how and what quality control checks are performed during the tablet manufacturing and how to measure tablet thickness and diameter. This video will cover all these three tests in detail. Official test includes weight variation, disintegration, dissolution, drug content, and non-official test includes hardness and friability. We'll start with hardness. Now, tablet requires certain amount of strength or hardness and resistance to friability to withstand mechanical shakes during handling in the manufacturing, packaging, and shipping. Hardness generally measures the tablet crushing strength or the load required to crush the tablet when it is placed on its edges. Tablet is placed on the edge and force is applied. When tablet just fractures, that force is recorded. Now, hardness measurement is also necessary to determine the need for pressure adjustment on the tableting machine. To determine the optimum pressure of compression, tablet hardness determination is important. If hard tablets are produced, pressure is reduced, and if soft tablets are produced, then pressure is increased. So it is necessary to determine the need for pressure adjustment on the tableting machine to produce sufficient hard tablet, as hardness can affect the disintegration. If the tablet is too hard, it may not disintegrate in required period of time, and if the tablet is too soft, it will not withstand the handling during the manufacturing, packaging, shipping, during the subsequent processing such as coating, etc. Okay, now method to check the hardness. A tablet is taken between the second and third finger and pressed with the thumb as a fulcrum. If the tablet breaks with a sharp snap, yet it does not break when it falls on the floor, is said to possess a proper hardness. Tablet is taken between the second, third finger and the thumb. It is pressed. It must break with a sharp snap, but it must not break when it falls on the floor. Then it is said to possess proper hardness. Okay, there are some instruments which will measure the hardness accurately. A tablet is placed between two anvils and the crushing strength that just causes the tablet to break is recorded. First is the Monsanto hardness tester. Force generated by the coil spring is applied diametrically to the tablet. This is the most commonly used and one of the earliest used testers. You can see in the figure, this tester contains barrel. Barrel contains a compressible spring held between the two plungers. Upper plunger is placed in contact with the tablet and zero read is taken. Lower plunger is forced against a spring until tablet fractures. As spring is compressed, the pointer rides along a gauge in the barrel to indicate the force. Then this force is recorded in kilograms. Second is Strongkov hardness tester. In this instrument, the force is applied by a manually operated air pump. As the pressure is increased, a plunger is moved or forced against the tablet placed on the anvil. Next is Pfizer hardness tester. Operates on the same mechanical principle as the ordinary pliers. You can see in the figure, the force required to break the tablet is recorded on a dial and expressed in either kilograms or pounds per force. Next is Schellinger hardness tester. It operates without manual involvement. Okay, you just have to press the on button, place the tablet between the plungers. Plungers will move, will break the tablet, and will display the force required to break the tablet. Next is Zerweka. You can see in the figure. Now, hardness of tablet is a function of the diaphil and compression force. At a constant diaphil, the hardness value increases and thickness decreases as additional compression force is applied. At diaphil, when the diaphil is constant and additional compression force is applied, hardness will increase and thickness will decrease. However, at a constant compression force, hardness increases with increasing diaphil and decreases with decrease in diaphil. At a constant compression force, if the diaphil will increase, hardness will increase. If the diaphil will decrease, hardness will decrease. Method of granulation. Wet granulation generally produces harder tablets. Amount of binder. More binder used, more hard the tablet is produced. Tablet diameter. Larger tablets require a greater force to cause fracture and are therefore harder than the smaller tablets. Hardness determination are made throughout the tablet run to determine the need for pressure adjustment on the tableting machine. At a fixed interval of time, generally 15 minutes, tablets are sampled and hardness and friability tests are performed. Okay, if harder tablets are produced, then the pressure is need to be decreased, and if the softer tablets are produced, then pressure is need to increase. So hardness determinations are made throughout the tablet run, say in every 15 minutes, to determine the need for pressure adjustment on the tableting machine. If the tablet is too hard, it may not disintegrate in the required period of time to meet the dissolution specifications. And if the tablet is too soft, it will not withstand the handling, packaging, shipping operations. Tablet hardness is not an absolute indication of the strength. Since some of the formulations, when compressed into very hard tablets, they tend to keep on attrition, losing their crown portions. Therefore, another measure of the tablet strength is its friability, and is often made. Okay, limits. Oral tablets have a hardness of 4 to 10 kg. For hypodermic and chewable tablets, they have hardness of 3 kg. Sustained release tablets have hardness of 10 to 20 kg. Make hardness test on 5 tablets, and then the average of these 5 tablets is taken. Okay, now we'll discuss about friability. Rather than measure of force required to crush tablets like hardness tester, this instrument is designed to evaluate ability of the tablet to withstand abrasion in the packaging, handling and shipping. Note down the initial weight of the tablets, we'll denote it with W initial. 20 tablets are placed in the plastic chamber which revolves at 25 rpm. You can see in the figure, this is the Roche friabilator. 20 tablets are placed in the plastic chamber which revolves at 25 rpm, and they are subjected to fall from a height of 6 inches in the friabilator for about 100 revolutions. So this will run for 4 minutes at 25 rpm. Tablet will fall from 6 inches. At the end of the operation, remove the tablet from the friabilator, de-dust and reweigh again. Now this is important that any tablet that breaks up should be rejected before reweighing. Friability is expressed as a percentage loss in weight. It is calculated as weight initial minus weight final upon weight initial into 100. Limits loss in weight 0.5 to 1% of the initial weight of the tablet should be considered as acceptable limits. Now, official test. First is disintegration. Disintegration is defined as the process of breakdown of tablet into smaller particles. Disintegration time of tablet is determined by using disintegration test apparatus as per IP specifications. Disintegration is defined as a state in which no residue of unit under test remains on the screen of the apparatus. If the residue remains, it consists of fragment of disintegrated part of tablet component parts such as insoluble coating of the tablet or of capsule shell, or any melted fatty substance from the pessary or suppository, or is a soft mass with no palpable core. The test is essential for tablets intended for administration by mouth, except those intended to be chewed before being swallowed, or those that dissolve slowly in the mouth, for example, lozenges, glycerol trinitrate, or effervescent tablets. So disintegration test does not apply on the chewable tablets, effervescent tablets or tablets that should dissolve slowly in the mouth like lozenges or glycerol trinitrate. Apparatus as per IP. The apparatus consists of a basket rack assembly, 1-liter beaker, a thermostatic arrangement for heating the fluid and a mechanical device for raising and lowering the basket in the immersion fluid at a constant frequency. Okay, now basket rack assembly. 6 cylindrical tubes, you can see in the figure, of length 77.5 plus minus 2 millimeter, 21.5 millimeter in the internal diameter, with the wall thickness of 2 millimeter. So there are 6 cylindrical tubes of 77.5 plus minus 2.5 millimeter in length, internal diameter is 21.5 millimeter, thickness of the wall is 2 millimeter. Now there are 2 superimposed transparent plastic plates which will hold these 6 cylinders. And these plastic plates are 90 plus minus 2 millimeter in diameter and 6.75 plus minus 1.75 millimeter thick, perforated by 6 holes having the same diameter as the tubes. Attached to the underside of the lower plate. Now attached to the lower plastic plate is a woven stainless steel wire cloth with 2 plus minus 0.2 millimeter mesh apparatus. This is important. Woven stainless steel wire cloth with 2 plus minus 0.2 millimeter mesh apparatus and with a wire diameter, and diameter of this wire is 0.615 plus minus 0.045 millimeter. Now, upper plate is covered with a stainless steel disc perforated by the six holes. Upper plate is just to hold these six tubes. So, upper plate is covered with a stainless steel disc perforated by the six holes. Each is about 24 plus minus 2 millimeter in diameter, which fits over the tubes and holds them between the plastic plates. Standard motor drive-in device is used to move the basket assembly containing the tablets up and down at a constant frequency of 28 and 32 cycles per minute through the distance of 50 to 60 millimeters. The change in the stroke direction should be smooth and not abrupt. Now, disc, a cylindrical disc for each tube, each 20.7 plus minus 0.15 millimeter thick in diameter and 9.5 plus minus 0.15 millimeter thick. You can see in the figure this disc is 20.7 millimeter in diameter and 9.5 millimeter in thickness. This is made up of a transparent plastic with relative density of 1.18 to 1.20 and pierced with 5 holes each of 2 millimeter. Four equally spaced grooves are cut in the lateral surface of the disc in such a way that upper surface of the disc, they have 9.5 mm wide and 2.5 mm deep. Medium. The volume of the liquid is such that the wire mesh at its highest point is at least 25 mm below the surface of the liquid. When the basket is at its higher point, the lower wire mesh, it should be at least 25 mm below the surface of the liquid. And at its lower point is at least 25 mm above the bottom of the beaker. At no time should the top of the basket rack assembly become submerged. Okay, there is a thermostatic arrangement for heating the liquid and maintaining the temperature at 37 plus minus 2 degrees Celsius. If one or two tablet fails to disintegrate, repeat the test on 12 tablets. Not less than 16 of the total 18 tablet tested disintegrate. Firstly, 6 tablets are taken in the disintegration assembly, out of which if 1 or 2 tablets fails to disintegrate, again the test is repeated on 12 tablets. So, total 18 tablets are taken, out of which not less than 16 tablets must disintegrate. Disintegration time of different tablets. Uncoated tablet, not more than 15 minutes. In water with disc at 37 degrees Celsius, plus minus 2 degrees Celsius. Coated tablets, not more than 30 minutes. In water with disc for film-coated tablets and not more than 16 minutes other than film-coated tablets. Enteric-coated tablet, according to IP, tablet remains intact for 2 hours in 0.1 molar HCl, that is stimulated gastric fluid, and disintegrate within 60 minutes in mixed 6.8 buffer phosphate buffer, stimulated intestinal fluid. According to USP, tablet remains intact for 1 hour in stimulated gastric fluid and disintegrate within 2 hours in stimulated intestinal fluid. These both are opposite. According to IP, tablet will remain intact for 2 hours in 0.1 molar HCl, that is stimulated gastric fluid, and disintegrate within 60 minutes in mixed 6.8 phosphate buffer. Dispersible or soluble tablets, within 3 minutes in water at 25 degrees Celsius plus minus 1 degree Celsius according to IP and 15 to 25 degrees Celsius in BP. Or a dispersible tablet within 1 minute. Effervescent tablets, 5 minutes in 250 ml water. 5 minutes in 250 ml water at 20 to 30 degrees Celsius according to IP. And 5 minutes in 200 ml water at 15 to 25 degrees Celsius in BP. Buccal and sublingual tablets, not applicable. Disintegration test is not applicable, but these buccal and sublingual tablets must dissolve within 15 to 30 minutes in mouth, slowly. Now, there are some important points. Perforated plastic discs are placed on the top of the tablets to impart an abrasive action to the tablets. They are useful for the tablets that float. USP disintegration test will pass if all the tablets disintegrate and particles pass through 10 mesh screen within the specified time. Disintegration time is suggested for 5 minutes for uncoated aspirin tablets, whereas for uncoated tablets, not more than 15. Okay, thank you for your time and attention. If you really like content of this video, please like the video and subscribe to my channel Pharma Guide. Guys, please watch my next video also. This will cover the weight variation, content uniformity and dissolution test in detail.